Hi, I'm Henry Liu.
And I'm Michelle TREMBLA.
And we'd like to welcome you to the SWAT News Show, hosted by Algonquin Regional High School.
We are members of the first Student Tech Support Team, also known as SWAT.
SWAT is an acronym for Students Working to Advance Technology.
We hope the segments of this news show will provide some guidance if you're interested in starting a Student Tech Support Team at your school.
Now we'd like to introduce our teacher and mentor, Mrs. Doyle, who is the founder of SWAT.
Hi, my name is Julie Doyle, and I'm the Instructional Technology Teacher at Algonquin. There are over 100 teachers here, and only one of me, so I am thrilled to have Henry and Michelle helping me to assist teachers to integrate technology into their curriculum. They have been extremely helpful in providing support, making tutorials, and basically helping me to achieve my goal to get more teachers to use technology more effectively to help students learn. Over the course of the semester, I have provided some basic training for Michelle and Henry, but what I have found most refreshing is how much I have learned from them.
I was originally part of the programming team and as well as a peer tutoring club here at Algonquin, so I thought I might as well expand my horizons and combine those two clubs and try out the newly formed tech support team. I was taught by my mentor, Mrs. Doyle, in how to use the technologies that students in other classes were using, such as iPads and green screens. And from my previous history of programming combined with what she has taught me, I was able to go into the classrooms and actively help out other students on their projects.
I joined the Student Tech Support Team at Algonquin because I am very interested in technology and computer science. I also love teaching others as well as myself more about it. I want to be a computer science major in college, so I feel this is a great step for me. I am learning a lot about technology myself from teaching others about it. What would be helpful and fun for me is to visit other schools with similar programs to see how they run their student tech support teams. It would also be really helpful to have trips to various technology companies and technology conferences. Why did Algonquin choose to have a student tech support team?
Well, we've had a goal for some years now of putting more technology into the classroom setting. And finally, I think that we have the capability of doing that. But it doesn't happen unless we have a good team. And Ms. Doyle has put together a great team. You're a part of that.
Thank you.
And because using students who are very savvy about technology is such a good idea, and it's really worked well.
What strategies were used to promote outreach?
Ms. Doyle came and she talked to everybody in the guidance staff. And so for us as guidance counselors, for me, what I did is I looked for kids who I felt met that criteria that were interested in technology, were interested in learning about this kind of thing, as well as could work with people, could talk to people.
And do you think this method of outreach was efficient?
I think we're at the beginning stages of this, so we're just starting. It's a new program for us. So one of the best ways is always as students are involved, for students to talk to other students, because that, in my opinion, is the best way to build a program.
Okay. It's validation of an existing skill set that they have, and when they work with their peers, it reinforces something that they know, and it's communication, and it is good for the student body. And we observe the interactions between the kids, and that peer-to-peer mentoring is really crucial in helping the kids access the curriculum.
Let's face it, the kids are much more tech-savvy than most of us adults.
It gives me confidence because I know if I have problems or if any of the students have problems, someone's right there to help. The students respond well to these other students because it's a peer-to-peer relationship and they tend to listen to their peers better than they listen to maybe their teachers. And it's just been a huge help.
Sometimes the students were more comfortable with his answer to how to go about something because we're not comfortable with the technology to begin with,
right.
So we might have approached it differently.
Yes.
So he was on their level.
And it's comforting for us to know that there is a resource that we can go to, a student resource in addition to a faculty resource that can, like you said, not only help us but help their peers who are more receptive to a peer of theirs than they would be necessarily to a teacher.
What would you provide to schools interested in starting a similar program?
I'd say go for it. I think they should do this. It took us many years to really come to this, but now that we have it, I think we're reaping the benefits of having technology in the classroom.
Thank you, Mr. Mead, for your advice, and thank you, fellow schools, for joining us.
And we wish you the best of luck in starting your own student tech support team.
Please feel free to contact us at Algonquin Regional High School with questions or comments.